afternoon. Welcome to Grant Thornton Sobera 2020 Virtual Summit. I will be your host today. My name is Payal. I study in class 11th, Lotus Petal Foundation. I hail from a small village located near Dausa in Rajasthan. My parents are laborers. No one in my family has ever received a formal education, nor have they got any opportunity to change their lives. Today, to anchor Sobera is a dream come true, and I'm grateful to my education for this opportunity. Moving on to our chief keynote session, I would like to invite Dr. Pritha Reddy, who is the Vice Chairperson of Apollo Hospitals Group, Asia's foremost integrated healthcare provider.
Payal, thank you. From coming from you, I think it's inspirational for all of us. It totally is a privilege to speak to you all and deliver this address and to be amongst people who do this kind of service to humanity at large. To me is a privilege. I love the name because, you know, when Sobera, especially in troubled times, in today's times, means a new dawn.
Thank you, Dr. Reddy, for that inspiring session. Request our guest of honor, Dr. Vivek Debroy, to share his perspective and continue to inspire us.
Any development that is not sustainable, however defined, has adverse impact on the lesser of segments of society, geographically, gender-wise, in terms of other indicators. India and this world will become better, not only because of what governments do, but because of what citizens, individuals and organizations do, which is why I come back to the point that I mentioned in the beginning. It is extremely important that something like Sobera recognizes, honors, and thereby disseminates the information that many individuals and organizations are doing to make Indian growth, Indian development more sustainable and environment friendly.
We are proud to have such a vibrant and diverse panel and look forward to some great learnings. Over to our moderator, Ms. Mahua Mukherjee.
They want to be not only measured on profits, which they were before, but also people and what they are doing for the planet.
What we have also observed is the level of trust. The programs, I'm not making a general statement, but it's a very, very conclusive statement from around last 5 years. We are observing this thing. We have the data and metrics to prove the programs which are woman-headed are performing better in terms of like delivering the behavior change messages on toilets, on making sure like the infant mortality rates are going down. Women are the change makers, like the villages we have chosen for our nutrition program, there is zero mortality.
This rich agro biodiversity, which gives Nanda an opportunity to have the assurance and insurance against market fluctuation and climatic fluctuations. In contrast, Shakuntala, her neighbor, is growing either cotton or soybean, as I said earlier, which is a monocrop, and with two crop as an intercrop in between. Now, if the year has failed climatically, means if it is not good for cotton or soybean, her entire crop is lost because it is a monocrop. There is nothing else to fall back on. The last 7 years' data show Nanda and Shakuntala, who have neighboring farms, almost at par. And in the last 7 years, there are 2 years of bad years of agriculture where Shakuntala has suffered losses. And in these 2 years, Nanda has not suffered any losses. There's a dip in production, but there is no loss. And this is an important point. So this agro-biodiverse farming gives Nanda a type of stability of income and production for herself.
We are doing a good program in the state of Uttarakhand, where we have reached out to the distant primary health clinics and also to the schools. We are providing electricity using the solar, not as a solar system provider, a service provider organization, but we are providing this in terms of enabler service to do the work better and provide better health and education services to the people, you know. Without electricity, you can't do this. And when we started this program, there was a need for providing refrigerators. So we provided refrigerators for storage. So right now, these dispensaries are handling dog bite, snake bite, and, you know, the other life-saving medicines using those refrigerators. But now, very soon now, they are going to handle coronavirus vaccine as well.
Women are equally to participate in the labor force of the country, then there would be a significant increase in the GDP of the countries, right? But despite that, unfortunately, in India, since last few years, we are witnessing a declining rate of labor force participation to the extent that it's really close to 20%, which is really, really below the world's average. Now, we also know that a lot of women, like majority, like over 90% of women work in the informal sector, unorganized sector, or they are in agriculture as well. And despite the fact that they perform majority of agricultural work, they are not considered as farmers, and therefore they are not, they can't access the services or the projects that are being targeted for women, for farmers on climate resilience. Now, this despite the fact that women do possess a lot of traditional knowledge on climate resilience.
We are moving on to the next session on importance of an integrated report, and research findings are being shared by Mr. Amit Kumar Bajaj, partner, Grant Thornton, Bharat. Over to you, Mr. Bajaj.
Thank you, Payal. Good afternoon, everyone. We are pleased to welcome you to this session on integrated reporting in India. Kedar Sipla is one of the early adopters of integrated reporting framework in India. What were the key reasons for the drivers behind this big shift for Sipla?
See, the feedback from the key stakeholders is outstanding, actually. I mean, the reception on this report that we have been publishing for the past 2-3 years is quite good. You know, see, internally, as a member of the management council, let's say I do have a lot of data, okay? But externally, when a company of this size commits to this significant level of transparency and starts measuring it, you know, stakeholders really appreciate it. It helps bridge the information asymmetry with external stakeholders, and they can understand the company much beyond.
All the investors and stakeholders are no more only looking into the profitability and the top line growth, but what they are also paying a lot of importance and relevance is with regard to the overall balanced disclosure.
ऑफिस के कपड़े
इम्पोर्टेंट प्रेजेंटेशन
इम्पोर्टेंट स्कूल प्रेजेंटेशन है
इन्हें भरोसा है आप पे और आपका भरोसा मैक्स लाइफ इंश्योरेंस के 99.22% क्लेम्स पेड रेशियो पे इंडिया के भरोसे का नंबर मैक्स लाइफ इंश्योरेंस
पार्टी का सामान
यू रॉक इट बिग
Presenting the big, bold and beautiful, all-new Nissan Magnite. Ignite your charisma.
पढ़ता है, खेलता है, झूलता, उछलता है, दौड़ता कभी कभी दौड़ कर रहता है, आगे आगे बढ़ता है इंडिया, अमूल दूध पीता है इंडिया.
Join the Room to Read in NDTV campaign Education Endures Back to School to support the education of children from economically weaker sections. To donate, log on to backtoschool.impactguru.com. Every donation will help develop literacy skills and reading habits amongst children from low-income communities. You can also donate online using these account details. Donate now to help transform lives.
Too much. दूसरे ज्वेलर्स जो वी डालते हैं वो है ज्यादा टू मच आपके ललिता ज्वेलरी में कंपेयर करके खरीदिए यू कैन सेव सो मच
गुड फीलिंग्स लास्ट अ फ्यू मंथ्स गुड एक्ट्स मोर देन अ लाइफ टाइम बी रिमेम्बर्ड फॉर गुड सीग्रम्स 100 पाइपर्स ट्रू लेजेंड
पहली महिला है जो घर से निकल के हमने बिजनेस अपना डाला
कि पहचान मिली कामयाबी मिली तो मतलब हर खुशी मिली
NDTV Usha Kushalta Ke Kadam Season 5 Saturday 10:30 PM and Sunday 8:30 AM only on NDTV 24/7.
Kushalta Ke Kadam brought to you by Usha.
किसे बात कर रहे हो?
तुम मुझ पे शक कर रही हो बेबी?
फोन बजे तुम बाथरूम में क्यों घुसाते?
अरे सिग्नल यहीं आता है।
तो नेटवर्क बदलो ना।
अब बिना अपना नंबर चेंज किए सिर्फ एक कॉल करके आसानी से अपना नेटवर्क बदले।
हैंड वॉशिंग एंड पर्सनल हाइजीन आर सो एब्सोल्युटली क्रूशियल। इट सेव्स लाइव्स ऑन अ स्केल वी कांट इवन इमेजिन। एंड आई थिंक इफ यू कैन कंबाइन दैट क्लीन टॉयलेट एंड clean life, that combination is just unbeatable. So that would be my mantra is clean toilet, clean life.
Myntra End of Reason Sale ab live hai. To aaj hi shop kijiye.
Get the biggest deals at the Myntra End of Reason Sale 20th to 24th December. Shop now.
They say aim for perfection, but you don't do it, do you?
No.
You go beyond perfection and you keep on going. And it's you that inspires us. We wake up every day and try to turn a wow into a whoa. Because just like you, we don't aim for perfection. We better.
Presenting Luminous Solar. Solar se paise bachao. Chalo India. Bijli banao.
Luminous. Khushiyon ka ghar.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to the third edition of Sabera. The Simply Suparna Media Network formulated the Sabera Awards with the objective to recognize, celebrate, and encourage the work done in the development sector from corporates to NGOs and even individuals working diligently to put our nation on the road to development.
Everyone whose entry we went through was a winner. They were winners of our admiration and respect for the great work that they are doing. And we would urge them and more to keep doing the good work, and we will pray that may their tribe increase.
Thank you so much, Siraj. Let's find out who the winners are. But first, let's find out how we conducted the jury and what all went into making this evening come alive tonight. Could we have the AV, please?
Welcome to the Grand Thornton Bharat Sabera, the Social and Business Enterprise Responsible Awards, a Simply Suparna Media Network initiative. GT Sabera 2020 acknowledges business and social enterprises along with individuals working responsible in putting the nation on the road to development in alignment with the SDGs. These may include individuals or societies, public or private sector units, NGOs or social enterprises. Our SDG partner is UN Global Compact Network India. There are three categories under which the awards are being given. Initiative awards, including CSR initiatives, non-governmental initiatives, or for-profit enterprise initiatives. Here, the entries were received from across the country, showcasing a wide variety of projects. Entity awards, recognizing leaders in corporate, not-for-profit, social causes, and entrepreneurial sectors. These are also open to nomination by the jury besides accepting entries. Individual awards, recognizing individual trailblazers, challenging status quo, and showing exemplary innovation and impact irrespective of the sector. The jury for the awards was led by Siraj Azmat Chaudhary, Managing Director and CEO, NCML, and it had representative leaders from a cross-section of society, people who are respected, trusted, and have a commitment to contribute towards the development of the nation.
Next, we have a keynote address from Sue Stephenson, co-founder, Impact 2030. Welcome, Ms. Stephenson. Thank you for connecting with us from US.
when the pandemic is over, there's going to be much written about the impacts, and I believe it will highlight that it was the responsible businesses that made the biggest contribution and have best weathered the storm. I mean, we listened to some of the extraordinary contributions being made by the award winners today, and I think that reinforces that. The Social and Business Enterprise Responsible Awards recognizes and celebrates organizations that are truly leading the way.
Responsible Business of the Year. Displaying exceptional commitment to sustainable development, engaging with all stakeholders, being an inclusive, ethical and transparent for-profit enterprise that can be public or private.
This award is to acknowledge the contribution of the work that is being done to empower women, and we are privileged from Tata Power that we can work with these communities, we can work with them to empower them and improve their quality of life.
First of all, on behalf of BPCL, I'd like to thank Sabira for considering BPCL for this prestigious award and acknowledging BPCL initiatives as a responsible business.
For us at HUL, we have a vision of making sustainable living commonplace, and we run the company with three beliefs, and these beliefs guide us every day. These beliefs are companies with purpose last, brands with purpose grow, and people with purpose thrive.
Hindustan Zinc continuously strives to take care of the communities and the environment in which it is operating. In this effort, Hindustan Zinc has already framed its sustainability goals that it wants to achieve by 2025.
We would like to thank the eminent jury members, Team Sabera, and all other stakeholders in recognizing the efforts of SIDBI and conferring the award to SIDBI.
Most Innovative Development Sector Project, an initiative that has displayed exemplary innovation and may have covered multiple challenges through its unique approach.
Of course, you have to look at the P&L balance sheet and cash flows, the old GAAP principles. But increasingly, the world is also moving towards integrated reporting. We just released a report, one integrated report, which I've encouraged you to have a look at. But basically, how are you going to align to the six capitals, which are financial, of course, but also human, intellectual, social, and so on and so forth. And I think by adopting an integrated report on how you're making an impact beyond just financials, is how we can be responsible businesses. And I think there's a role there for regulators to make the shift, to actually encourage businesses to start adopting integrated reporting. There's over 100 companies in India that are already doing that. But I think the time for, you know, GAAP will be over by 2030. Can we expedite that and actually encourage companies to think of themselves in that integrated fashion on how they're going to make an impact across those six capitals that framework prescribes.
The Best Integrated Report Award, acknowledging companies with the best integrated reportage. Paryavaran aur Upbhog, environment and consumption. Initiatives including but not limited to waste management, recycling water, restoring water and terrestrial ecosystems, mitigating impact of climate change, and of course renewable and affordable energy, sanitation management, sustainable production and consumption. Shiksha, education. Initiatives include but not limited to encourage affordable primary and secondary education, skill development, disability sensitivity, eliminating gender disparity in education, and increasing scholarships. Not-for-profit of the year, displaying exceptional commitment to development through consistent innovation, impact, monitoring and evaluation, and displaying high levels of ethics and transparency by a non-profit venture. Changemakers, Grant Thornton Bharat Sabera are recognizing individual trailblazers that have challenged status quo. They may be from any field. Social Leader of the Year, an individual leading an NGO or a CSR team, and should be above 30 years of age.
At Nayara Energy, we work consistently and incessantly as a part of our local community, residents who make and try to make a change for the better for the local community in terms of their well-being and in terms of the social economic impact. We have various communities, various social partners who help us implement our projects on ground. The government of Gujarat, along with UNICEF, UNDP, JSIR&T India Foundation, and Indian Institute of Public Health are all examples of NGOs which help us to implement our various socio-economic programs that are meaningful for communities in and around our refinery.
So this foundation is very happy to receive Sabera Award for Not-for-Profit of the Year. Thank you very much. We are working in rural Raigad and Nashik districts of Maharashtra. The mission of Sadhis Foundation is to lift 1 million people out of poverty every 5 to 7 years. We work towards making permanent positive change in the lives of rural people. And our commitment only goes up with such kind of recognition. Such recognition go a long way in motivating not just Team Sadhis, but also our community members.
Thank you so much, GT Sabera, for this honor. I am very happy today that an initiative which had started with one person in Tata Hospital in Bombay today has a team of 450 people, has become a movement which is working across the country for the underprivileged cancer patients. And I'm very sure that this kind of acknowledgement will go a long way in encouraging the team and instilling that confidence that yes, we are on the right path.
I am grateful to the jury members of the GTB Sabera 2020 Awards for conferring on me the Change Maker of the Year Award. I am thankful to every member of Impact India Foundation, to our staff in the field for convincing a needy patient in a remote rural area that his disability can be corrected free of cost, to the impact worker in our community health initiative who brings home to the family of a malnourished pregnant tribal woman the need for frequent antenatal care checkups to give birth to a healthy daughter or son. This award is dedicated to Impact India Foundation staff of 52 change makers, board of trustees, funders, doctors, and so many others.
Jai Durge. The Rig Veda states, Aham Rashtri Sang Mani Vasunam. These are the ethos for Sabera, which I mentored. What does this mean? The Vasunams are the dwellers who have been empowered by the divine and have the capability of conducting transactions because they have the material with them. In today's world, this will translate to the industry. And the others which are Sangmani, which are also part of the dwellings, are the other end of those who are not so fortunate, but they get together, they create movements, NGOs and other such entities to be able to do this transaction. Both together are the definition of a Rashtra. Therefore, the Divine Goddess says, Aham Rashtri Sangamani Vasunam. Sabera's ethos is the same. It is an attempt to bring the two parts together so that transactions can occur and the nation can rise to its greatest heights as a fair equity to all.
What a journey this has been. What you saw here is the sweat, blood and grime of a few of the Sabera team members over the last year. And all the winners, congratulations. You're all winners, all of you who participated through Sabera 2020. Thank you all. God bless you. And hopefully we shall all meet in person real soon in 2021. Till we roll out the next edition of Sabera 2021, stay safe, take care, and be well. Thank you.